Dave's house the other night to watch a game. It's the first time I think I've been in the house since he got married. I was totally impressed. It's like, oh my God.
Diana's finished.
Oh yeah. Got all these nice incense candles burning around. Everything is so tidy and clean. It's like, man, that's
so weird.
No fun.
I said,
no longer.
Really? Well, for Christmas we go over there and she had the fanciest dishes and, like you said, candles and all decorated and all over the place.
We
don't
do that anymore. That's kind of tough. She's kind of going through the drawers now too. Instead of yeah, like more tools under kitchen drawers, you know, some of that. kind of get things more reorganized.
I should talk that after Diana moved here, she's here a couple of weeks, and I go to the cabin at the lake, and on the coffee table, she's got about 30, 35 pair of reader glasses. I go, where'd those come from? She said, I found them laying all over the place.
Oh,
and she washed them.
She washed them?
Yes.
She lost all?
She washed.
Oh, washed them. I thought you said she washed. How did you?
There's a lot of times fingerprints all over the place.
When she came back, I said, well, what's Diana doing? He goes, oh, she's cleaning and organized. I said, well, that's going to keep her busy for years. So no problem.
He cleaned the garage out there.
They hadn't done the one at the house here, had they? The one at the house is the one that really did.
Yeah.
And then, you know, you go into the public bathroom in that house. Man, I was afraid to use it. I mean, it was so. I've never. Maybe usually you've gone in there. It's not even any toilet paper or towels or anything or soap. You know.
Oh, oh, you're gonna get. I'm gonna get him in trouble here. After Janet died, I can't remember who it was, but they started going through Dave's old condiments, like ketchup and mustard stuff, but it was. Way outdated. That is, don't you dare tell them, dude. That is so funny to me.
I'll just, next time I go over there for food, I'll check the date on the kitchen.
It should all be good.
I'm sure she had quite the
obviously job. She was good for him, because that place is really nice now. Yeah, I guess she lost that one. That's too bad.
Yeah.
And I couldn't believe he's taking a liking to that cat.
Yeah,
like, you're not going to like that.
Yeah.
Because he said, oh, yeah, she's got this big fat cat. Well, I'm over there, and he goes, pats the couch and says, come on, Lighter, or whatever the name is, you know, just wanting the cat to come on.
Okay.
He likes the cat.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
We're so happy to have you all here tonight. I'm Jane Gates with the Stiefel Theatre. I've got John Richards, our chairman of the board, and Norm Yankee, who headed up the tower project and the original renovation as well. And we just wanted to share turning on the lights with you guys. It's just really an unbelievable event, and when you think about this time that we're living in and this tower, and I really believe, and I want forever and ever for people to look to this tower as a beacon of hope and love, and how we come together and we celebrate life and we celebrate the arts and music in this community. We draw people from all over the country to see shows here. And I'm just so proud of this community and the support that we have had to make this theater what it is in its original grandeur. You know, it originally opened in 1931, and I've been reading back over some of the history and the vision and the incredible stories of how this theater was built originally. It was just a faith journey the whole time. When Mr. Watson bought this piece of land and decided that he wanted to build a theater, there was concern that they wouldn't have enough people from the region to come in and support it. But look what happened. Now, in 1950, many people have was lightning and a bad storm that destroyed the top of the tower. And at that time, the theater decided that they would take down the top couple of tiers and the spire and just, you know, leave it as it was. It was still a beautiful building. But a couple of years ago, Norm Yankee came to me and he said, I've got some people that want to rebuild the tower. And I said, you're kidding. And long story short, we had some people come forward that really felt that with everything happening in this community, and this theater is such a beautiful, beautiful theater, it was time to rebuild this tower. And it was rebuilt with the help of Jones, Gillum's, Wren, Hutton, all the magnificent contractors, and once again, Norm Yankee heading up the project. It was rebuilt to its original grandeur. In fact, the very same number of lights were installed. Everything about it was literally meticulously done to rebuild this tower exactly as it was built in 1931. Everything about this tower and everything we've done here has been made possible with private donations. In fact, we still have a little bit left to go. So if you would like to donate to this tower and this project and be a part of it, just contact the Stiefel. I want to thank the donors that have made this tower project possible. Everybody that's made the downtown renovations possible. It's unbelievable what's happening in this community. I'm involved all over the, you know, with theaters, and it's unprecedented what's happening in this downtown and to this theater, and this community should be so proud. But I want to thank Norm Yankee, who I just asked him, you know, what was it, Norm, that made you want to get involved in the original renovation and then to take on the tower? And you've been a board member all these years, on and off. You've been on the executive committee, and I think when the building originally renovated and opened in 2003, I think Christy told me you spent about a year and a half, about 18 hours a day down here. And you know, you made it possible for this tower renovation. I mean, it's an incredible gift that you've given this theater. And I just can't say enough about Jones, Gillum, Wren's architects, Jeff, Maggie Gillum. We were in touch constantly about this tower, every detail, and also Hutton Construction, and then all the contractors that were involved. I don't know if any of you were down here with Perko, who was putting on the spire. It was wonderful. It's just been amazing to watch how much talent there is with the contractors. And the GEMS, I want to thank the GEMS organization. Christy Yankee headed this up with Maggie Gillum, Maggie Hemmer, Shannon Rail, Lynn Ryan, and Carolyn Wheelan. This was a group that really got together when the theater was originally renovated, and they kind of figured out the Friends organization, which is an important source of income for the theater and all the benefits. The GEMS got back together again and really put together this event for us tonight. So a big thank you also to the GEMS, and staff, April, Jaime, Bill Tazika, you guys have been amazing. And last but not least, our board of directors, who is so comfortable embracing risk and being supportive. They're amazing. And I'm going to turn it over to John Richards, and we're going to turn on the lights. And we've had a sneak preview, and you just won't believe it. So, John?
Well, I just want to thank everybody again, just the way Jane did. I know a lot of you out here probably are already friends of Stiefel. I think what we've been through the last year has really shown us how truly wonderful our friends are, because you talk about taking a risk when you have an here because of our friends, and I just want to thank all of you tremendously on behalf of the board, and I hope you all enjoy the show.
Okay, so with that, get ready. We're going to turn on the lights.
I can't understand what went wrong. I mean, we never did it. She was so active. She just wanted to work and retire. Yeah, that's display at the Salina Community Theater too. They said they never turn them on.
Oh.
Just only when there's a production.
Yeah.
On.
See you guys later.
Thank you.
don't have it right now, but once in a while we have.
All right.
Have a good day.
Shots?
Dark.
What it is in the dark, yeah.
Thank you.
hey guys!
Oh, hi! Hey. How are you?
How are you?
I just took my rate.
Cool, yeah, I love it.
Fox Theater sign back.